Hello everybody and welcome to this new episode of our project, which is the e-commerce using Laravel. So the last episode we have added some models and some migrations. In this one we are going to move to the next model, which is the user model. We will add some fields in the fillable. So we will add some fields. The first one is the active. The active will be used to see, to check if the user has activated his account or not, and we will have a code. This one is the code for activation or is an activation code. Next we will have the relation between the user and the orders. So user will have many orders. This has many order class. As many order, what is wrong here? I forgot to add this one. So next we will move to the user migration. Then we will add this we will add these fields. Let's check where is the user migration. This is the first one. So here we will add the fields that we have in the fill level, which are the active, which will be string, not string but a boolean, which will be active, and by default will be zero, which means the account is not active. And we will have another one for the code to activate the account, and code will be nullable, which will be by default null. So this is the this is the user migration. Next, what we have next? So I think that this is the what we have until now, and we will add more. We will add admin models, and when we reach the admin section, we will add the models. The admin models. Now let's stick just for the front end, and when we hit the back end we will see the admin back end. Let's me check just the migrations here, the factories, seeders and factories. So here we used order, here we used products, and I will see here we have the category factory. Let's check here. And here just I'm checking just imports are using order and the user, the products. So to avoid any error, here the products, and here we have the user. Okay, and here in the create password resets, we have to add this 191 beside the emails. I think failed jobs, I think this is all. And I think I need the seeder for the user. We need seeder. I will add a new seeder for the user, PHP artisan make seeder user seeder. Okay, it's here, and here we will call the factory user, and we will create 10 users, and we call the method which is create. So now let's add in the PHP my admin. let's add let's add a new database. I have already a Laravel e-commerce database, but this one was for the projects. This was for the projects that we have done, that I have done before. So now I will create a new one. You can create a new database in your PHP MyAdmin. You name it whatever you want, and here you add it in the in file to connect to the Laravel. For me, I will call it e-commerce English, name of the database. I will call it Laravel e-commerce English. So add your database, and in the in file you add the you connect to your database. So just waiting, it took some time to load the PHP MyAdmin. So we add our database, and next we choose the I will go with the UTF general CE. We create our database. So our database is here, and we are connected to our database. So let's migrate our files. I will use PHP Artisan Migrate. And I have something wrong here, and that's why I tried to avoid this kind of errors too long. Users user email unique. Okay, I will back. I did already check for this. It's here, it's in the users table. I forgot this one. You can in service provider, you can import schema and set the max character to 191 to avoid this error. So here I will try again. I will migrate, I will roll back or fresh to migrates, because some tables are already migrated. I forget. Migrate fresh to fresh. Migrate. I don't know what happened. Why this typo errors? So our database migrated. Next, we seed the data, the pseed database seeding completed. So let's see our database here. I forget to call the seeders that we have added. So for now our tables are here, but we have no records. So I forget to in the database seeder here, I forgot to call the table, the classes that we have added before. We have the table seeder, and we will order them as we will make them ordered. First we will start with the user seeder, because the product and order need the user ID. So we will use the user seeder first, next the category seeder, and next we will add the product seeder, and the final one will be the order seeder. This one we don't need it. So let's check another. It says that the user seeder does not exist. If you face this kind of errors, just empty the cache. You can empty the cache using composer auto temp auto load. Run this command to empty the cache, and I will wait some seconds until it's finished, and then we will send our database. So after finishing the optimization, we will run the command once again, and I think that we have the same error. What is this error? The user seeder. I think that I misspelled. It's user seeder, not users seeder. It's user seeder. We will run it again, and this time we have another one, which means category not found. Where is the category not found? Where category not found in the which file? Here is missing app category. We will check. I think in seeders we have here the app category already, and in the products we don't have the app category. That's why, no, not here, but in the factory. The factory here we don't have the category. We will import. So don't forget to import category here in the top. Next, let's try again. We have another one, which is the column in stock is not found into the products. I already added the in stock. It was in stock and not in stock. It was just a typo. So try to fix it and run the migrate fresh to migrate again, because we have that typo error, and send the data again. We will send the db seed. So this time everything is done correctly. We have here the categories, and we have the migrations, we have the orders, and we have the products, and we have the users. So just for here, because we did not truncate our table, that's why it's here, it's 20 characters, 20 records, and for the users also. So that is okay. We will use it just for demonstration. So now we have done with our database. I think we will move to the next part, which is the user register and the user email validation. Let me check our projects. We have here the login and the register. So what we want is, once a user is registered, as we said before, it will be logged out, and we will be redirected to the login page, and email will be sent to his email address to confirm or to activate his account before he logs in. So let's start. First of all, we will go to the register controller here in the register control, or we will add another controller before we tackle the register controller. We will add another one, php artisan make controller, and we will call it activate accounts controller, and we hit enter. This controller, we have I think we'll have two functions. First one is to activate your account, and second one is for resending the activation account. So let's move to the added controller, activate account controller. Here we will add first function, public function. This one is activation. We will call the function activation, and it will receive the code to activate the user account. First we will get the user with the code that we have here. We will check for the code, and we get the first user. Next we will remove the code because the user is activating his account, so the code we will set it to null. Next we will update this user. We update the user and we set active, which means that his account has been activated, and we set it to 1 or 0. Next we will log the user. We'll use auth login the user. So the account is activated. Now the user is logged. Next we will redirect the user. Return redirect the user, and we will redirect the user to slash or to the home page with success with success message, and we will show connected. For the second one, which is the function for asking another code to activate the account, we will name it resend code. This one will receive the email of the user who is asking for the code. We will find the user by his email, where email is the same as the email we have here, and we get the first one. So after we get the user, we check if the user is already active. If he already activated or he has activated his account, we will redirect him to the home page. If not, we will send an email to the user, and this email will go to the user. We send another class. We will add a mail account. This mail account we will name it activates the mail class, not the mail account. We will send a mail class or a mail notification to the user. Activate your account. We will name it activate your account. This class will receive the user code, and this user code will be sent to the user who is asking for a new code, and then we will redirect the user to the login page, and we will inform the user with success message that we have sent a link was sent to your email address. We will inform the user that we have sent the link again. So what we need to add, we need to add this mail class. So we will add it, php artisan make mail, and we give name of the class, which is activate your account. So the mail was added, and here we import this class. Don't forget to import the class, which will be in the app mail activate your account. Next we will move to the mail class that we have added, I think that we will add the contents of this class, or we add it now and next episode we check for the functionality if it is working or not. Okay, we will hear, we will receive, as we said before, we will receive a code. We add a variable, public code, and a URL. The URL will the user will be redirected after he not redirected, but the URL for the user that he will use to activate his account, as we have seen here in the activation account. When we call class activate your account, here we give it the code of the user. So here in the constructor we will receive the code. This is the code that we will receive, and we will give it to the variable code that we have already added. And for the URL will be the URL for the routes to activate the account. We will add a route, we will name it a user activate, and this route will take the code. So, and finally we will use the markdown to send the view, which will be this one, the view that we have seen here. This is the view that we will send to the user, and this view will be in the views folder, in one folder named emails, and we will name the view activate user account. We will add this view. So here in the email, in the views folder, let's move to the resource views. We will add folder emails, and inside this folder we will add activate user email plate.php. This is the view that will be sent to the user, this one. So here, okay, here we will have the contents, this one that we have here. I think that I will stop here, and next episode we will add the contents of this file, and we will test our functionality if it is working or not. So see you in next episode.